everybody, and welcome to the Jamey Chadwell Show here at North Greenville University, where Christ makes the difference. I'm your host, Fred Battenfield. Well, Coach, I know you had a wide variety of thoughts and emotions that must have been going through your mind this past weekend. What were you thinking the first time you walked out on that field at Charleston?
I was hoping I was going to the right sideline, to be honest with you, because I didn't even know how the visitor's locker room looked. And so all of it was it was a surreal experience, to be honest with you. I was excited about being down there with my team and taking them down there, and because I spent 5 years down there. It was one of the best 5 years of my life, and the place meant a lot to me, but I was excited about taking them down there. But seeing some of the players that you got to know personally and recruited, and they're out there making some plays on you, I wasn't happy for them at that time, I'll be honest. But after the game, you know, and seeing them, watch them came up to me and told them to miss me and said, hey, I know you're going to do well up there. That meant a lot. So it was the extreme, you know, low to high, obviously, seeing the kids and caring about them, but obviously excited about our guys being there and what we want to become is model ourselves after what Charleston's done with their football program, and we're taking those right steps.
Well, you move on to the next level. You're a head coach now. You've had a chance to make your own mark.
That's right. And you know, and seeing the kids that sit down there and afterwards, you hope as a coach, you coach because you want to compete and have a chance to win, but most importantly, you do it for the relationships. And to see those kids come up to me that hopefully you mentored during the time, that meant a lot. And it showed me that what I'm doing and what we're doing as a staff here is we're in the right direction, because we're approaching it the same way, and we want our kids to have that same feeling about us. And so, the game didn't turn out the way we wanted to, but it let us know, hey, we're heading in the right direction.
Well, Coach, it seemed like the Crusaders started out strong in the game, but Charleston Southern's experience and depth finally caught up with you.
It did. I mean, anytime you're playing a team that's, you know, got 60-something scholarships and, you know, has been an established program, everything's got to go right for you. And we were talking to our team yesterday. It's 10-0 with about 2 minutes to go in half. We got a chance to make a play down there to put us inside the 20 to either score 3 points or a touchdown, and now the pressure's on them. You know, because we're not expected to win, but we just every time there's an opportunity for us to make a play or something, we're not doing it. And then the other team sort of seizes that moment and their experience and takes over a little bit. So I was pleased as far as where we were at in the game. I mean, you want to try to shorten the game when you're playing somebody that much better than you. And we did. We're 2 minutes, 10-0. You're feeling good, and then we don't get it, and they score right before halftime and sort of took the wind out of ourselves. And so, you know, there's things that we can learn from there. And we're just hoping we're learning a lot these last 5 games. Hopefully we'll start learning from a victory or so.
Well, I hope so. You're at the midway point of the season. What would be the checklist at this point?
Well, I think as a coach, you, no matter what, wins, losses, you look, okay, from game one to the middle of the season, game five, have we improved? And as you look, you know, as the offense, have we improved in a lot of areas? Yes. Have we improved the way we wanted to? No. Defensively, same way, we improved a lot of areas. And I felt, you know, I think the part that we improved most is probably the kicking game. I think we went a little backwards in game five, but it had something to do with Charleston. But I feel like we've improved a lot from that area. So we've improved in a lot of areas, but just not enough to the point where we can win the games we need to win. We're not good enough as a team not to do things right all the time.
Well, can you give me an example of a few of the individual players that might have showed up that might not have been in the statistics or on the tout board, so to speak, in the past couple games?
Well, I think, you know, a guy that showed up maybe a little earlier in the season and then has sort of been under the radar, played. He started at defensive back, was a returner. J.J. Fullwood, I think, had a really exceptional game. Did well. And then I think an Isaiah Johnson, that's another young guy that's a returner also, he started at corner in the secondary and played pretty well. Two young guys that get an opportunity, taking the most of it there, I think are showing up. I think, you know, on offense, our running back, Josh Murph, is a guy that got a chance to play last week, did some decent things, and continue to do some positive things this week. So those are guys that a lot of people don't know about that are steadily improving each week, and coaches are taking notice of them.
That's what the coaches should be looking mm-hmm. for. Well, Coach, you're in the middle of a really tough 4-game road schedule right now. You played at Lenoir Rhyne. You played at Charleston Southern. Now you've got to go down to Jacksonville, Florida to play Edward Waters. Obviously, it's a chance to be a big lift to get a victory this weekend.
Oh, definitely. You know, anytime you can, with where you're at in your program right now, anytime you get a chance to go out, compete again, and get a victory, It's obviously important. You know, going on the road is tough, especially the distances that we have to go and what we're doing. But our guys have been extremely, the word I'm looking for, they're still working. They're still striking the stone, you know, and they're still coming to show up and wanting to do the things right. They take the video and say, hey, this is what I didn't do right. Our leadership's been good. So I feel positive that we're going to go down there and get some victory.
Oh, great. Well, Coach, you know, we can't really look ahead a little bit, but the next home game, obviously, is October 17th. That's homecoming, and mm-hmm. I know the team will definitely be looking forward to getting back to Yount Stadium to play again.
Yeah, because, you know, you get tired of not sleeping in your own bed and being able to get up and do the things you normally do at home. So I think it's good. You know, sometimes as a young team, I think you build your character when you're on the road because it's 65 of you versus whoever else is down there, you know. So we get a chance to do some bonding that maybe you don't get to do as home because you're on bus trips or you may be in a hotel room. And so there's some bonding that goes on the road that I think our team needs to get us to the next level. But we're definitely looking forward to getting home and getting in front of the home fans.
Well, Coach, I know your coaching staff has been working extremely hard to prepare the team each and every week. And you kind of have to give them a pat on the back, don't you?
Yeah, you know, you're only as good as your assistant coaches, and I feel like I got some of the best around. They do a great job. Most importantly, they love the kids, and they care about them more than just what we're trying to teach them on this football field, what they're going to do with their lives. And I've just been pleased with how they're interacting with the kids and trying to mentor to them and do things and help them become the men they're supposed to be.
Oh, that's great. Well, Coach, next week we have a victory to talk about.
That's right.
Well, Coach, fans, if you can't make it down to Jacksonville this weekend, follow the game on 95.5 FM, The Vibe. Coach Jamey Chadwell, I'm Fred Battenfield. This is the Crusader Sports Network.